Hi, welcome to Total Learn. Interesting facts about Allama Muhammad Iqbal. Allama Muhammad Iqbal remained a controversial figure in history of the Indian subcontinent. Sarojini Naidu called him the poet laureate of Asia. On the one hand, he is considered the spiritual father of Pakistan. On the other, his message of Eastern revivalism places him in the rank of 20th century's major intellectuals. Iqbal's tragedy was that after his death, he was made the national poet of Pakistan and largely ignored in India. In his time, he was lauded as much as Tagore, but today India celebrates Tagore while Iqbal has been banished from her consciousness. He born on November 9, 1877, died at the age of 60, also known as Allama Iqbal. He born on Sialkot, Punjab, British India. He is famous for poet and philosopher. His spouses Karim Bibi, Mukhtar Begum and Sardar Begum. His father name was Sheikh Noor Muhammad. His mother name was Imam Bibi. His children Aftab Iqbal, Javed Iqbal and Miraj Begum. He died on April 21, 1938, place of death Lahore, Punjab, British India. He is believed to be the inspiration behind the historical Pakistan movement, in which he was one of the few leaders who first received the idea of Pakistan as a different nation for the Muslims. Iqbal was a very learned man who did a considerable part of his studies in India and some in England and Germany, where he was introduced to philosophies of Goethe, Heine and Nietzsche. While studying abroad, he became a member of London branch of the All India Muslim League. Iqbal practiced law in India for some time after returning and later entered the politics and was known for his legal expertise, political ideologies and groundwork and philosophical theories. He is fondly remembered as a great poet and scholar. With his book like Rumat-Jay, Bakudi, Jabur-e-Azam, etc., he became the one of the most important contributors to the Urdu literature. For his talents and extraordinary personality, he was knighted by King George V in 1922. Let's see his early life. Muhammad Iqbal was born in Sialkot in Punjab, province of British India, to Sheikh Noor Muhammad and Imam Bibi. His father was not an educated man and worked as a tailor while his mother was a homemaker. At the age of 4, Iqbal was introduced to religious studies and was sent to mosque to learn Quran. He learned Arabic language at Scotch Mission College in Sialkot and pursued his intermediate from the Faculty of Arts, Murray College. In 1895, Iqbal enrolled in Government College Lahore for his bachelor's to study philosophy, English literature and Arabic. He also received his Master's of Arts degree from the same college and secured number one position in Punjab University, Lahore. Let's see his career. Iqbal finished his Master of Arts degree and started his academic career as a reader of Arabic at Oriental College, but within a short period of time, he became a junior professor of philosophy at Government College, Lahore. Iqbal opted for higher studies in the West and to travel to England to study on the scholarship from Trinity College, Cambridge, and received his Bachelor's of Arts degree from the same in 1906. In 1907, he went to Germany to pursue doctorate and PhD degree from the Ludwig Maximilian University, Munich. During the process, he got his doctoral thesis, The Development of Metaphysics in Persia, published. He returned to India and became an assistant professor at Government College Lahore, but job did not provide enough financial support, which is why he decided to turn to practice of law. He practiced as a lawyer from 1908 to 1934. In 1919, he became the general secretary of Anjuman-e-Himayat-e-Islam, an Islamic intellectual and political organization based in Lahore, Pakistan, which he was an active member of many years before gaining this position. 1927, Iqbal was elected to the Punjab Legislative Assembly and was later elected to preside over the session of Muslim League. It was in this position that he for the first time introduced the idea of Pakistan. Due to his failing health, Iqbal stopped practicing law altogether in 1934 and was honored with the pension by the Nawab of Bhopal. He dedicated his life to his own spiritual upliftment and contributing to the Persian and Urdu literature. Some of the books written by the Iqbals are Payam-e Mushrik, The Reconstruction of Religious Thoughts in Islam, Javed-Nama, Paste Bayad Kad Kume Shark, Bale Jubril, Jarbe Kalim, etc. Let's see his major works. Iqbal was known for his legal expertise and political ideologies, but it was as a poet that he is still fondly remembered. With the books like Rumuj-e-Behudi, Jabr-e-Azam, etc., his contribution to Urdu literature is immense. Let's see his personal life. Iqbal married 3 times in his life. His first marriage, held on 1895, was with Karim Bibi and had 2 children with her, Miraj Begum and Aftab Iqbal. His second marriage was with the Sardar Begum and third was Ukhtar Begum at 1914. He died in 1938 in Lahore after suffering for many years from various illness, which started with a mysterious throat illness that he developed on his trip to Spain and Afghanistan. His tomb was erected in Hazuri Bagh, Pakistan. He is regarded as the Sher-e-Mushrik. In most Southeast Asia, he is also called Mufakir-e-Pakistan and Hakim-ul-Ummat. He is Pakistan's national poet and his birthday is a national holiday there. He is the author of Sare Jahan Se Acha. In Iran and Afghanistan, he is famous as Iqbal-e-Lahori. His son Javed Iqbal served as a justice on the Supreme Court of Pakistan. Many public institutions in Pakistan are named after him. Some of them are the Allama Iqbal Campus, Punjab University in Lahore, the Allama Iqbal Medical College in Lahore, Iqbal Stadium in Faisalabad, Allama Iqbal Open University in Pakistan. For reference book, please go through the description section under this video. Thanks for watching. Thank you.